I'm Christopher Zweig in Bar Harbor, Maine, giving you reviews of some new movies, including a made-for-Netflix film based on a Nickelodeon show, a post-9/11 drama starring Michael Keaton and Stanley Tucci, and a quarantine comedy starring James McAvoy and Sharon Horgan. Let's take a look. Our first movie is The Loud House Movie, a made-for-Netflix spin-off of one of the most popular Nickelodeon cartoons about the only boy in a family of 10 girls who all head out to Scotland to find their roots, and they turn out to be of royal descent.
What are you doing, honey?
Duking.
Right in front of us?
You know we have our own bathrooms now.
There's an unnecessary villain who just wants peace and quiet. She's sort of a Squidward wannabe as far as I'm concerned, but for the kids and animation fans, the Loud House movie has a good-natured tone, with some funny moments, good songs, and fun animation. In its own terms, it does a good job, so check it out. Our next movie is Together, a quarantine comedy set between the COVID-19 lockdown of March 2020 and the vaccination distribution of this year. Directed by Stephen Daldry, it stars James McAvoy and Sharon Horgan as a mismatched couple who would have broken up if they didn't have a son. Now with the virus out, they have no choice but to bunker down together.
Now I think you've got the same level of charm as diarrhea in a pint glass. I'm worried about Mum.
Little Artie, he's only got one grandparent.
Hospital was weird. It's just try and make sure that people don't die alone.
Both my parents are dead, so you know, thank God.
That's really grim.
I know, I was thinking that as I was saying it, it's a bit grim.
Throughout their quarantine, they break the fourth wall like they're being interviewed on The Office.
I don't want to go back to normal. Running towards each other at the speed of light, shouting, get away from me. I can't do that anymore. We did it in the kitchen this morning.
Over the dishwasher, I mean, that is unfathomable.
What are you?
Now, I'm going to have to assume that Bleecker Street, which distributes Together, wants to have the same kind of success that IFC Films had with The Trip because they're allowing such talented actors to cut back on the commercialism and portray characters with a broad sense of humor. And both these comedies premiered on the BBC back in the UK as either a miniseries or a made-for-TV movie. It may make some people uncomfortable given the circumstances Delta variant, but I like this movie for McAvoy and Horgan's connection and for its goofy, offbeat nature. And our last movie is Worth, a riveting and emotional post-9/11 drama starring Michael Keaton as lawyer Kenneth Feinberg, who has been appointed as the special master of the September 11 Victim Compensation Fund, which would benefit the families of the 9/11 victims.
The victims and their families will be compensated based on economic value loss.
That's where the formula comes in. 80%.
Any fewer come aboard, the lawsuits that result could crater the economy.
There are those who believe this organization is some kind of a scam, and in comes a community organizer who tries to wake the lawyer up. He's played by Stanley Tucci.
But we can't bend the rules for every case.
Why not? Congress gives you broad discretion, but when 7,000 citizens ask you not to be treated like some numbers on a spreadsheet, you act like that law came down from Sinai.
Worth shows sympathy for some of the relatives of the deceased, and they're used with the sincere emotions I've seen with The Molested in Spotlight. And like that film, it gives Michael Keaton and Stanley Tucci their convictions. Not everyone gets their basis, but it still keeps us involved with what this true story needed to accomplish, learning about the values of others and what this horrific event has done to them. It's challenging and emotional, so check it out. Now let's recap the movies I reviewed today. Thumbs up for The Loud House Movie. Despite its lackluster villain, it manages to have some heart and charm for the kids. More thumbs up for Together, a quarantine comedy with its offbeat sense of humor and two charming leads. And finally, thumbs up for Worth, an entertaining post-9/11 drama about doing what's right, especially during one of the worst tragedies in history. It opens this Friday in select cities and comes on Netflix next Friday. I'm Christopher Zweig in Bar Harbor, Maine, and I'll see you at the movies. For more amazing content, please like and subscribe to my channels. You can also read my reviews at cjatthemovies.com and listen to my podcast reviews at newhdradio.com.